students, welcome in your English class. Today we are going to revise the chapter simple present tense. Okay, you all know about simple present tense because I have already explained this chapter, but I am going to revise what is simple present tense. Okay, so in brief I will tell you what is simple present tense. Simple present tense is when we use a verb to tell about anything which happens continually in present or like every day, every week or every month. Okay, we can use simple present tense for the action that happens regularly. That happens regularly, or sometimes you can say it never happens. Okay, like if I give the example, she enjoys playing badminton. She enjoys playing badminton. She is the subject here. And what is the verb? Enjoys is the verb. Actually, the main verb is, or the base verb is, what is the base verb? Enjoy. It is the base verb, and I have added S to the base verb to make the sentence in simple present tense. That means it is clear that in simple present tense we use verb first form. First form, you can say first form or the base form, both the things are same. Verb first form plus S or ES with the verb. This is, you can say, the formula for simple present tense. Okay, she enjoys playing badminton. By this sentence, it is clear that at present also she enjoys. That means, if I give another example, like he goes to school every day. He is the subject here, goes. See, goes is the verb which is go plus es. Go plus es. Here also we have added es. See, here I have added es and here I have added s with the base form. And now read the whole sentence. She enjoys playing badminton. What time this sentence is indicating? This is indicating past, that at past she enjoyed? No, it would have been enjoyed d. But here it is saying she enjoys. Enjoys means currently, or she enjoys playing badminton. At present, she enjoys playing badminton. He goes to school every day. He goes. Goes means it is a daily habit. He goes to school. It happens continually. Daily it is happening. Okay. Now this was of, you can say, I have talked about she or he. This is which person? This is third person. If I talk about first person, what is the first person? You know, I is the first person. If I talk about I, it will be I go to school, right? Why I go to school? I have not added here es or s. Why? Because I have already explained in my previous video, like I is the strongest person in grammar and I don't require any helping verb. I don't require any help, like S or ES. It doesn't require any help. It is the strongest person. You can. Now we also know that simple present tense, we use simple present tense when we use simple present tense when we want to show some universal fact. Okay, when we want to say about any universal fact, like the moon moves around the earth. The moon moves around the earth. This is a universal fact and it happens and it will happen also. So here we see that the subject is the moon and we have added es, we have added s to the base verb. Move plus s. We have added s to the base verb. Okay, so it is clear that for universal truth also we are going to add simple present tense. We are going to express. Now we say we use simple present tense one more at one more place where we use simple present tense to talk about anything which will happen in future but already decided in present or already decided in the current time. Like suppose if a person is going to retire, so we all know that he is going to retire at certain time. So next year grandfather retires. Okay, retires, s, retire is the base verb and s is added to the, retired is the base verb and s is added to the base verb. Now if I give another example, next week I go to any place, like if I say Goa, next week I go to go. Why go? Because I have used the word I. If I say next week she goes to Goa, that means next week she goes to Goa. It is already decided in present that next week she goes to Goa. So this is the basic topic of simple present tense, where we use simple present tense, where one thing, that is when we see anything which is happening regularly or at regular interval. Secondly, when there is any universal truth that it is happening forever and it will happen forever, then we use simple present tense. Now the third thing is when we have decided anything that will happen in future but it is decided today or it is decided in the current time, then we use simple present tense. Now we will discuss certain points where to use s or where to use es. These things we are going to discuss now. Now we are going to see certain words are there, like certain alphabets are there, like O, C, H, S, 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 H, X. These alphabets are there. When the verb ends on these alphabets and having a singular subject, then we add es to the verb. I repeat, when a verb ends on O, CH, SS, SH or X, then we add ES when the subject is singular. Okay. Now, when the verb doesn't end on all these things, then we add S. When the verb doesn't end on all these things, then we add S to the verb. Like sleeps, eats, rises. Don't get confused that here it is ES. Rise is the base verb and I have added S only. Okay, these things you have to keep in mind. Now we will talk about one more thing, do or does. You have come across these words also, do or does. Whether it is a negative sentence, whether it is an interrogative sentence, we use does with singular subject and do with plural subject. I repeat, we use does with singular subject and we use do with the plural subject. Okay. Now what about negative sentence? I have already said for negative also and for interrogative sentences, this will only be the formula. Now what is negative sentence? You all know negative sentence is having something no, neither, nor or any negative feeling. Okay. So here also does not will be there, do not will be there. Clear? but the concept will be same. Do not for plural subject and does not for singular subject. It is placed where? It is placed before verb. Before verb. Okay, now one more thing I want to say. It resembles the base form of verb that I have already said. Base form is here. Okay, and it is S or ES. It is added where it is added to the third person. What about imperative sentences? Imperative sentences also, here in imperative sentences, we don't change the form of verb. We keep the base form only. In imperative sentence, we keep the base form. In imperative sentence, we keep the base form. Like suppose if I say, bring a glass of water. I have not changed the form of verb. I have just ordered, like, bring a glass of water. Imperative sentence, you all know that imperative sentence means the sentence which is having what? Any order or command or any request. All these things are in imperative sentence. Now, when I'm talking about imperative sentence, I don't change the base form of verb. It will always be in the base form. That means in simple present tense, base form of verb will not change in case of imperative sentences. Okay, let's see. Now, it's all clear, I think. Now, let's discuss some examples. Certain revision. Just see the board here. Circle the verb in the following sentences. Here I have written four sentences and you have to circle the verb. Okay, these all sentences are in simple present tense. Okay, so we have to do what? We have to circle the verb. First sentence, children run very fast. Children, subject. What is the verb here? Run. Action is shown by the verb run. The children go to school by bus. Go. The train departs in 5 minutes. Departs. Owls sleep during the day. Sleep. So all these are verb here. Okay. Now we are going to do another exercise which will help you to understand better simple present tense. Okay. Now see here. Underline the correct word in the brackets in each sentences. Here I have given some verbs. You have to select which verb will suit the line. Okay, first sentence. She loves her pet even more than herself. She is a single person and I need a help. So I will use loves. She loves her pet even more than herself. Second sentence, Rohit makes a noise in the classroom. What will be the answer? Rohit is again a single person, so it will require the help. Makes. Rohit makes a noise in the classroom. Third sentence, Mr. Rawat knocks at the door. Mr. Rawat is also a single person. Mr. Rawat knocks at the door. Next, she takes care of her little puppy. She, single person, takes care of her little puppy. You know one thing, why I have always used one single person, just to explain you, like she, Rohit, Mr. Rawat, again she, all these are what? These are different forms of single person only. Okay, so we can use all these are the different form of single person. Like it can come in he, she form. It can come in a single name form. It can come with a title, or you can say any way. If it comes, then also we use, if it is a single person, we use S or ES with the verb. This exercise we have done just to show you that a single person can be in any form. Okay. Now we will do the third exercise, which will also enhance your knowledge about simple present tense. Now see the third exercise, true false. Okay, this tense means simple present tense, also applies to some of the events that will happen in the future. This sentence is true or false? This sentence is talking about future. So is it true or false? This sentence is true. Why? Because in simple present tense, I have already said that some event which will happen in future, but it is decided at present or at current time that it will happen. It is already decided in present. So this sentence is true. Okay. Now let's read the second sentence. Present is the time in which a work is continuing to happen. Any work which is going on at this current time, that is what? That is present tense or not? What it is? So, but obviously we are talking about simple present tense, and present is only the time which is showing which work is going on right now. So this sentence is also true. Now, third sentence, if an event takes place at regular intervals, it falls into the simple present tense. This is in the definition only I have explained that simple present tense, at regular intervals, certain work happens. Okay, so this sentence is also true. So I hope you all understood means what is simple present tense. I have explained you. I have tried my best to explain you, and I have tried to clear all the doubts which you can have regarding simple present tense. You have to keep in mind verb first form, S or ES is added to it with singular subject. Okay, and that is also third person. Okay. I have done various exercises where I have shown you how to means identify verb. In the next exercise, I have explained how to use S or ES with the word we have to add, or where we have to means avoid it. Third, we have done with true false also. It can come in this type in the exam also, like whether the sentence is true or false. You have to keep in mind the definition, or at the time of explaining what I have said regarding simple present tense. These are also the important things to keep in mind. That's all for today, and that's all for simple present tense. Best of luck for your exams.